As per some studies, it is expected that by 2020, around 30.73 billion electronic devices will be connected to internet, which will rise to 70.44 billion by 2025. These numbers demand a much more higher bandwidth than the existing 4th generation communication network. This is where 5G comes in, of course. 5G is widely believed to be smarter, faster, and more efficient than 4G. It promises mobile data speeds that far outstrip the fastest home broadband network currently available to consumers. 5G is not just for smartphones, that's just one part of it. The technology will be essential for self-driving cars, smart homes, unmanned aircrafts, consumer technologies like wearable virtual reality headsets, cloud computing, even for baby diapers in the future. Today, let us find out some of the core technologies which are used to make 5G a reality. Before we move on, if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, feel free to subscribe and turn on notifications to continue watching more tech-related videos from Tech Review. Number 1. Millimeter wave. Think of millimeter wave spectrum as a superhighway. Now picture fleets of tractor trailers moving gigantic shipments of data in all directions on the roadway. But instead of these individual small lanes, imagine there are tens of thousands of gigantic lanes put together. That's how they are delivering 5G, and that's where you see the massive difference in ability to deliver this kind of bandwidth. That's cool, but why millimeter wave? All the electronic devices in our home use specific radio frequency spectrum, which are typically restricted to frequencies up to 30 GHz. This range is currently highly congested. Hence, modern wireless communication standards are focusing more on standards over 30 GHz. The possibility of achieving data rates of up to 10 gigabit per second, whereas the data rates are restricted to less than 1 gigabit per second in microwave frequencies, has increased the application of millimeter waves to automatic radar solutions, high-speed point-to-point communications, streaming high-resolution videos, and wireless networks. Number 2. Massive MIMO. MIMO stands for Multiple Input, Multiple Output, which is a method for multiplying the capacity of a radio link using multiple transmit and receive antennas to exploit multipath propagation. At one time, in wireless term, MIMO referred to the use of multiple antenna at the transmitter and receiver. In modern usage, MIMO specifically refers to a practical technique for sending and receiving more than one data signal simultaneously over the same radio channel by exploiting multipath propagation. Standard MIMO networks tend to use 2 or 4 antennas. On the other hand, a massive MIMO uses number of antennas more than the number of users. There is as much as a 50-fold increase in the channel capacity with massive MIMO, which means many users can communicate with the base station at the same time with the same frequency without interfering with each other. Number 3. Beamforming. Beamforming, or spatial filtration, is a signal processing technique used in sensor arrays for directional signal transmission or reception. The figure illustrates how massive MIMO works in practice. An antenna array of 50 omni elements with half wavelength spacing in between the antenna elements is used here. The 50 element transmit distinct streams of data, one stream for each user equipment. All four streams are transmitted using the same physical resource block, that is, the same time or frequency resources. The data streams do not interfere between each other because each of them has a distinct radiation pattern where the signal strength in the direction of the targeted user equipment is optimized, and in the direction of the other user equipments, the signal strength is minimized. This is one of the major technological breakthroughs which enables the communication network with longer range and very high data rates without interfering with the adjacent users. Number 4. Full duplex. Full duplex allow a node to transmit and receive simultaneously in the same frequency band, thus theoretically doubling the system throughput over the conventional half duplex system. A key limitation in building a feasible full duplex node is the self-interference, that is, the interference generated by the transmitted signal to the desired signal received on the same node. This constraint has been overcome given the recent advances in self-interference cancellation technology. There are many other technologies like small cells, direct RF sampling, CPFDM, and so on, which are being tested to make the fifth generation communication network to completely transform the communication industry with enormous data capacity, rapid speeds, and incredibly low latency. 5G marks a huge step up from its predecessor. We have a lot more to talk about 5G and its related technologies in the coming videos. Share your thoughts about 5G in the comment box. Stay tuned to Tech Reveal for future videos. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.